Hello everybody, I'm Ricardo, I'm an engineer at iMaker, and today we will be speaking about the Anisoprene Composer A4. We will navigate a few aspects of it, and you will see why we think that is the best available system for continuous carbon fiber in the market. We will assume that you know the differences between open and closed systems in terms of additive manufacturing. In both cases, you will find pros and cons, and this is something that will be related only to your needs. And there's no better or worse system. This is always depending on your actual needs, your own production. Still, with this unit, you can achieve some levels of freedom and customization that are really remarkable. So we really think that you might actually think twice about pros or cons. But how do we translate this concept of open or closed to the Anisoprene case? Well, it's quite simple. You can use their own materials, but also they offer you the chance of using third-party materials. They even give you the profiles to do that. Plus, you can use different lattice structures in different areas, totally customized, and not only the outer perimeters. So you are really speaking or truly reinforced part in the most efficient way. So it is completely open and customizable, everything. The only thing that you will have to get from them is the actual fibers, which will be either carbon or basalt. That's the only thing. The rest is a completely open machine. It's something that is really, really remarkable for us. One thing that I find fair to share with you is the fact that whenever you are navigating in depth an open system like this one, that means more experimentation on many occasions, more trial and error, and not necessarily a plug and play print on absolutely every print. If you are navigating a new material that there are not even profiles about it, then you will have to experiment, you will have to do trials, errors. So this will actually depend literally on where you stand as a user. Might be the right fit for you, maybe not, but for most of our customers, it's actually the most ideal solution available. Let's now take a look to the composers. They are two options, A4 and A3. Of course, the difference is on the size, on the build volume. Otherwise, it's the same machine and the same software. Exactly the same, just bigger. You have A3 being 420 by 297 by 210, or the A4, a bit smaller, of course, you have 297 by 210 by 140 millimeters. In terms of which materials you can use with the composer, the spectrum is quite wide, to be honest, and we suggest you the limit of printing temperature being 270 degrees Celsius. But still, we can give you some examples, and those could be PLA, ABS, ASA, TPU, PC, PP, and of course, nylons. The actual materials provided by Anisoprene are nylons. They are two. Of course, you have the fibers that they are mandatory to be purchased from them, but the nylons that come with it are the smooth one that you would use, for example, in outer shells, and those have tiny pieces of chopped fiber inside, and they will give this black opaque finish that is really beautiful. And then you have the CFC nylon, which is basically the one that you would be co-extruding with the fiber, and that's simply nylon, plain, no color, no nothing. It's simply something, a plastic material to co-extrude to actually reinforce the part. If you wonder about the economic aspect, actually Anisoprene is really friendly, it's really efficient, as they are cutting all the unnecessary extra cost of hardware. You have some competitors that are charging you up to 3 times for their solutions, but the savings are only starting there, because it's not only cheaper from that point of view. As I said, the only materials you have to purchase from them are the fibers. The materials for plastics, you can just get them from anywhere. They are third party, they are open, it's not a problem. Depending on the license you get, you might get already the profiles, or you might have to develop them yourself. And that's actually the other extra cost, which is super reasonable in any case, which is license. Depending on what's your need, actually you might have to get a paid license. They are really cheap, and they give you, you can gain the full control of the operation. And by the way, if you are an institution for educational purposes, most likely you will be avoiding the cost of the licenses too. Some statistics. You can check the case studies at Anisoprene's website and analyze them in detail. In those you will see results like the following ones, but bear in mind, these values are from different case studies altogether. So depending on your print, you would achieve multiple of the following items. Some of those could be parts that are 20 times stronger than plastic, 7 times lighter than steel, 12% reduction of weight, 28% of reduction of final parts price,
10 times energy savings, and many other ones. When speaking of the reinforced soft jaws, you're speaking of 40% cheaper, 35% lighter than metal ones, and they produce up to 15 times more cycles than the conventional plastic jaws. Last but not least, we have these legs of a mobile robot, and in this one we are speaking of manufacturing cost reduced by 40% and 70% of weight reduction.
Okay everybody, this was the introduction for the Anisoprene Composer A4. We will be speaking in following videos about the technical aspects of it, what's the logic about printing composites, a little bit about licensing as well, and finally our tips from our own experience for you if you are starting your journey with printing carbon fiber. Thank you very much, see you on the next video.